Welcome back guys. Today we see some example on the trigger. Okay, today we see some example on the trigger. Okay, now trigger is one object. So how we create a trigger? With the help of create or replace trigger. Suppose my trigger name is trig underscore one. Okay, now after that first specify the timing. Okay, suppose my timing is before. Okay, and then event. What is my event here? Let's perform one DML event, and the name of that event is suppose insert. So before insert, my action will perform over here. Okay, that's why we specify the timing into our trigger. So before insert means insert is my event. So before insert, the executable of that trigger will perform their action. Clear? Now on table name, suppose my table name is emp1. Okay, then when we are perform the insert event, then there is row level trigger. This is the type of trigger which is always apply when you perform the insert event. Okay, so what is your row level? For each row, it's default, or you enter always row level trigger when you perform the insert event. Clear? Then executable part starts. Now what is my action? Suppose my action is that I want to display one message, and my message is dbms underscore output dot put underscore line, and please wait while your value inserting. Okay, so this is my message. Okay, or I want to display this message when we perform any event on that table. So this action is automatically done by your trigger. Okay, show error, set server output on. Clear? Trigger created. Now let's perform insert. First describe the table emp1. So there are the three columns. Let's insert a value. Insert into emp1. Suppose one ID, then name. Suppose my name is Oracle, and date of birth suppose sys date. Clear? So when we perform this insert event, at that time this message will automatically fired by your trigger. Okay, Oracle. Okay, sorry. Okay, I forget to values. Now see, please wait while your value inserting. Okay, now this message is automatically fired by your Oracle, because Oracle is always fired a trigger automatically when this event will perform on that table. Okay, so this is how we use the insert event. Now into your trigger you can use your multiple DM element like this. This is the special ifs condition. Now here we see how we use the multiple event and how we deal with that multiple conditional. Insert or update, insert or update or delete. You can specify your multiple event over here. Now suppose if, how we use the special if statement into our trigger. See, if inserting, then please display this message. Okay, spelling mistake. If inserting, then please display this message. Okay, now suppose if updating, then okay, please wait while your value updating. Clear? While your value is updating. Now what is your third? This is if inserting then an else if and else. What is the else part? Else, what is my again DBMS? Please wait while your value is deleting. Okay, so this is the special if statement. After that, end of if. This is your special if statement, okay, which you use into a trigger or for a specific event. Okay, when you perform the insert event, then automatically this action will perform. When you perform the update event, then automatically this else if part will execute it. And when you perform the delete, then this else part will execute it. Clear? So this is the special if. If inserting, else if updating, else, this is your default. Okay, now let's check. Trigger created. First clear it. Suppose now insert, clear one row, select star from EMP1. Okay, now let's update EMP1, set name equal to single quote, suppose red hat, where id equal to 1. Clear? Then enter. Now see, it display two values. Why? Because your event will perform two operations, first for this row, second for this. So that's why it's for each row this trigger type will display your message two times. First update this row, then immediately display the message, please wait while your transaction is waiting, updating. Now immediately this second row is updating, at that time again second message will display. So this is for each row. Suppose here we specify the statement level, then this action will display only the one time. Clear? So like this we can use the multiple event and special if statement into your trigger. Clear? Suppose let delete, suppose I am delete, fired the delete from EMP1 where id equal to 1. Then again it display your action or message two times because your event will perform two times, and here for each row level is enable. Clear? So this is about the special if condition into your trigger and how we use the multiple event into your trigger. Thank you.